The Slow Tempo by WeGotGuru, a podcast series about anything and everything related to music. Hello everyone and welcome to the Slow Tempo podcast presented by WeGotGuru. I am Rishi and I am here with my friend and colleague Vikas.
How are you doing?
Hi Vikas, good. Because we've been talking about, you know, music and bands and, you know, some of our previous conversations. So today I thought, you know, maybe we could talk about, you know, interesting music videos.
Oh, for sure. You know?
So when I say interesting music videos, what pops into your mind?
Yeah, so I think music videos should have not just good music, it should have, you know, a lyrical attribute also in the sense of the way it's been shot, you know. And of course, as a cinematographer, I believe, you know, subtext of the video.
Right.
And, you know, most music videos, you know, I don't think they should be the best ones. They don't get understood, you know.
At the first go. Right.
They're always misunderstood. Right. And then later on, but there are some other videos that actually, you know, you watch it in the first go and you're like, wow, what did
right.
I just watch?
Right.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I think some, you know, timeless ones which typically stand out for all of us,
exactly.
You know, like, you know, MJ's Thriller or Like a Prayer by Madonna, or, you know, if you could go back to some of the Aerosmith videos, you know, all like mini movies,
exactly.
They had like, you know, almost like a story, exactly. Entire story, long story shown in
8 minutes,
yeah, and GNR's Number Rain, you know, or something like that, right? You know, the not just well shot, but, you know, it's
even storytelling.
It's like storytelling,
yeah.
Right? And of course, there are, you know, nowadays probably with the advent of, you know, graphics and green screens, it's much more, you know, technically easier for a lot more capabilities, unlike earlier,
exactly, you know,
when everything was just really shot live or in a studio kind of stuff without all these gimmicks. I'm not underplaying, you know, the current ones by saying gimmicks, but, you know, you did not have all this technical, you know, stuff available at that time. So maybe mention a few which really worked for you or, you know, made you go, oh, wow, or, hey, what was that and stuff.
I do have one video I really love to talk about. It's called Virtual Insanity.
Right, okay.
Yeah, I think by
Jamiroquai.
Right. That's how you pronounce it.
Yeah.
So, of course, the video, it starts with, I mean, there's only him dancing, but what's so beautiful about his video is not only his dancing, but also the fact that everything moves.
Right.
In the camera.
The entire set is moving.
The entire set is moving, right.
So, you know, so we were talking about, you know, interesting music videos, but, you know, we could also talk about really wacky ones. You know, I always go back to this song called Where's Your Head At? I think by Basement Jacks. Mm-hmm. So if you're not, you know, checked it out, go check it out, you know, but also warn you that, you know, it will give you the creeps. Not in the sense that it's horror or, you know, some similar genre, but there is this, you know, like a music producer guy who's actually gone to a place to kind of, you know, audition somebody, but he finds himself in kind of like a weird animal lab, and there's this guy in a lab coat. At first, you know, he shows him, you know, like some toy models of, you know, some monkeys. Trying to play, you know, like a toy guitar and stuff like that. And then this producer moves, is taken to another part of the building, which is like a, you know, like a music studio, and there are actual monkeys performing and playing and singing, and And it gets weirder because, you know, soon their faces change to the band members' faces.
Okay.
And then he's obviously creeped out, and a bunch of things happen. I don't want to reveal everything. But yes, it's like, you know, real somebody's weird nightmare coming true, or you know, some animal lab gone wrong with some crazy experiment or some clone and half clone and stuff like that.
It sounds and like all of that.
All of that. So, and you know, at the end, I could relate to the title of the song. You know, where's your head at? So you know, it actually gave me you know, kind of the creeps. So go and check it out. And see, you know, what it does to you.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So you're saying that people's faces,
yes,
animals' faces.
Yeah, and animals playing music and singing, and it's not just you know, monkeys, but there are some other stuff too. Yeah.
Some other animals.
Yeah, yeah. Just go and check.
Objects maybe.
Oh, I don't want to say everything, but you know.
I just want to say some Snapchat thing, you know.
Now that you say it, I think these guys,
they did it beforehand.
Much before, you know, somebody came up with Snapchat and all these animal filters, I suppose they have. I personally haven't used it, but you know, I've seen quite a few, you know, viral videos and stuff where people put on all this weird stuff.
It's called,
but I think it's creepier than, you know, Snapchat filters.
Right.
So you should definitely check it out. You know, Basement Jacks. Where's your head at? Yes. You know, Christopher Walken dancing to Fatboy Slim's Weapon of Choice. Right, and you know, for me, just to see him growing to the music, and the way he does so effortlessly is just stands out. Right. I'm sure they had, you know, all kinds of, you know, cords and strings attached where he was, because he was hanging in the air, and you know, but that's Christopher Walken hanging in the air and bouncing off walls. Right. I also read that probably this was, you know, kind of very impromptu and not really too choreographed in that in advance kind of stuff.
But by the look on his face, he will be like, I got this.
Yeah,
he's always got it.
Absolutely. Yeah. He was just like, you know, a guy who stumbles upon this music and really likes it, and you know, impromptu just starts dancing and grooving.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, that's how it felt for me. Yeah, yeah, that's one that will.
Especially if a man that age, right?
Right.
To be dancing like
right,
that.
Right. Right.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, that's something that stands out for me. Yeah. Anything else in your list that comes to your mind?
Yes, Smells Like Teen Spirit.
Right, Nirvana. Yeah.
I mean, subtly done, but too iconic.
Right.
I mean, the whole premise of the video was, you know, an anarchist pep rally happening at school, right?
So, right.
So Nirvana was there, and even the Nirvana wanted people to be the extras.
Right.
So they just called up, they kind of called in their fans and they asked them, could you be the bleachers?
Right. Okay.
And they were like, cool.
Right.
But
okay,
they were all just tired of being on set for 12 hours straight, doing nothing but just losing their minds to
the
song.
But it was Nirvana.
But it was Nirvana.
And I think, you know, if you're a fan, you would.
That's the part I don't get, you know. I mean, like, you're a Nirvana.
But I understand that. you know, the waiting probably gets to you, because you know shooting is not what we see on screen, but you know, for a fan of that band to be present in that song and you know, look back at it, you know, 15, 20 years down the line, or tell your grandchildren, hey, I was
part of
the crowd when it was shot, is something to write about, right?
So I think what Kurt Cobain did, like, to have some fun, he just told the guys to thrash the set.
In the end, right, when it happens, well, yeah. Well, okay.
I think that's then the end of the video, the ending segment, right? Yep. So that's just Kurt saying, everyone, just thrash the set and have fun.
Right. So now that you waited 12 hours, you know, go ahead.
Go ahead and just ruin the damn thing.
Wow. Okay.
So, yeah, that was one of the videos that stood out for me. Interesting. It was like such a easy topic, I mean, you know, but it was done more easily also, you know.
Right.
Because, I mean, when people hear anarchist, you know, they think of other complex things.
Right,
but
right.
These guys just did it so effortlessly.
Yeah. Interesting. So I think that's, you know, from the discussion, I have quite a few video recommendations that I should definitely go back and check for, you know, different elements, and, you know, a couple of them that I mentioned, I think you should go back and check out for their weirdness or, you know, wackiness.
Yep.
And I think we should definitely catch up sometime soon and talk more music.
Totally, yeah.
Right? So thank you for tuning in, and we hope to be back with a new episode soon. Thank you.
Sure.
Bye.
Bye. Take care.
Our next episode will be up soon. Thanks for tuning in.